Right, it's me, Nathan. I'm back here with another review. This is the M-Audio AV32 Active Reference Monitor Speakers. Okay, so let's get right into it. Right, here we have the box. Straight up, you get a picture of the speakers right in the front. Same sides, another picture of the speakers, same on both sides. At the back here, you've got another picture of the speakers, and it seems like a small introduction and some features of the speakers. So these speakers do have the 3-inch woofers, and they are, according to this, polypropylene coated woofers. Try to say that 3 times fast. They have 1-inch ferrofluid cooled silk dome tweeters, and these speakers are 10 watts. Okay, I'm not gonna keep going on about that because, yeah. Basically, let's get right into this. I forgot to sharpen my knife. How good is that? Okay, so straight up inside the box, we got the user guide. Okay, check that out later. What's this? This is the safety instructions and warranty information. That's it, we get straight into the packaging. Got some polystyrene protection for the speakers here, and there we have them. Damn. Okay, so of course right here we have the RCA to 3.5mm jack connection. 3.5 to 3.5mm jack, and the speaker wire to connect both speakers. Here we got the power cable, standard UK 3-prong 230 volts, and here we have the speakers themselves. These are nice. Okay, and of course the slave unit. Also the box, we have some foam pads to stick underneath, help with the acoustics. That's pretty good. Okay, so let's unwrap these. Oh, where do we start first? Okay, so power cable. How do I open this? When in doubt, use brute force. Okay, so they have cable ties in them, it's pretty nice. Okay, so that's the power cord. This bag's a little easier. These are silver plated cables, so don't expect anything too fancy with the cables. Don't get me wrong, they're good cables. Okay, so the speakers. Why do they make these things so difficult to get into? Ah, I get it. Here we have the speaker. Oh, that's nice. That's very nice. Okay, so these are the speakers. These do not have grills on them. They have this very cool technology where you can push in these little things, the domes, they'll pop straight back out. So if you've got anything in the house where, like, kids or pets, you're worried about them touching these, pushing them in, no, they're totally safe. They pop straight back out, don't worry. Yeah, so that's very nice. Room two. Okay, so this one's the amplified unit. So with these ones, we have the volume control right here. We have a AUX input and a headphone jack. So if you've got these things hooked up to your desktop, you don't have to pull them out to use your headphones. And also if you want to plug in something like a phone, just to listen to something on your phone real quick, you don't have to take out the wires either. You just plug it straight into the front. So on the back right here, we see you got the power input the power switch and the RCA input also. We also have the output to the right speaker. That is one thing about these speakers, is that you don't have a switch on the back to choose which is left and which is right. Let's say you felt more comfortable with the volume being on the left or the right, you don't get that option. This is left, this is right. So if you do want to know which one's which, if that's going to affect your setup at all in any sort of way, the slave unit is on the right and the amplified unit with the volume and everything's on the left. So yeah, that's these speakers. Pretty nice. Also, for demonstration purposes, really quickly, I'm going to put the little foam pads in the bottom of the speakers just to show. Okay, so right here, I got this speaker. So the foam pads are on sticky. They have like a sticky coat and you just peel them off. Stick them right on. Now I'm a bit OCD when it comes to stuff like this, so I'm gonna have to make these perfectly aligned. Awesome. So these things are really, how awkward would that be if I put it on the bottom? These things are really easy to stick on. There's no effort. A 4-year-old could do it. Saying that, don't let your 4-year-old do it, because that just wouldn't be a good idea in the long run. So yeah, it's that easy, these things. Now at least have some sort of acoustic insulation from the surface put on. Obviously you can buy the big foam pads to actually stick them on, which will work much better, but I don't have the space in my setup to do that, as you'll see later. So right, we're gonna do a test. These speakers, they do need to be broken in, basically meaning when they come straight out of the box, they're gonna sound like shit. But after you play them on a decent volume for a couple of hours, they're gonna sound amazing. Sorry about that. So yeah, let's give that a try then. Okay, so right now I'm in my room. We set the speakers up. And yes, we're ready to do a sound test. We're gonna be doing this with a microphone and set this up in the center of the stereo image from the speakers so you guys can sort of get an idea of what these sound like. Okay, awesome, let's get right into it. Okay, so I guess that pretty much wraps it up. For a comparison to my voice right now, I'm using the mic I use to record the sound of the speakers, so you can sort of get a rough idea. There was a bit of static in the background of the sound. I don't know if that has something to do with the mic or the computer itself, but I guess it sort of works anyway. It'll give you a rough idea of how these things sound. They, take it from me, they're pretty good. Also, early on in the video, I also said that the left speaker is stuck on the left, right's on the right, so if you want your volume on the right, yeah, good luck. I was incorrect to say that. I'm not sure if you know these are designed to do this, but considering they use an Since they use a RCA input, you could just switch the left to the right terminal and the right to the left terminal, and then basically doing that, the speaker with the volume becomes the right speaker. So you can have the volume rocker on which side, ever side you want, really. So yeah, that wraps it up. This is a pretty good pair of speakers, so you should definitely buy them if you need them. Do remember, these are professional studio monitors, so they're more for professional /prosumer people. So if you're not in necessary need to get them, just get a good pair of multimedia speakers, really. You know, that's all you need. So yeah, thanks for watching. Peace out, man. I have a feeling my parents are not going to approve of these speakers at all. Well.